Hey guys, in this video, my friend Linda is going to talk about 10 years living in Cambodia as a European expat. Find out what it's like to fall in love, make money, and find a house here. Let's go. I think this is probably our guy here. 1186. So how's your day going, ladies?
Yeah, rusting. Just rusting.
Yeah.
Nothing big going on?
No, last night was big, so.
Oh, really? Tell me more. What happened last night?
Chinese wine.
Oh, no!
Like whiskey.
Baijiu,
yeah.
Oh, why did you do that?
Because last night was a holiday, like the finishing of the Lunar New Year. So people meet up and eat and drink.
And these were Chinese friends of yours?
Yes. I only have Chinese friends.
Why is that?
Because I speak Chinese.
Oh, yeah. So there's a lot of Chinese here.
Yeah.
What are they all doing here, your friends?
All sort of stuff. I have one friend who is also doing yoga training, dance training. But the rest of them is pretty much my students. So they work in a bank or opening a restaurant.
So Linda actually bought a house here. She's been here for so long. And maybe you could tell us about that process.
Well, I saw pretty much everything from the apartments to the villas and all sort of stuff. But mostly the location was a problem. Good apartments cost $3,000 per square meter. So $120 you will just get a one bedroom.
Okay.
But a good location, so which is really small. The rooms are really small. So in the end, I decided to take a four-story house, which was a slightly more expensive, but it's acceptable. It's a lot of land. It's a bit far, but takes me around 30 minutes from the city center.
Are you actually allowed to fully own property here as a foreigner?
Yes, but only upstairs. So in the house, you cannot like just have a contract with the developer. You can sell it and everything, but you don't have the hard title as a foreigner.
Okay.
Hopefully I will be able to get the nationality one day. It is really expensive though.
Okay, so you can apply for...
I can, but I'll try. It's getting more and more expensive.
And do you have to like learn Khmer to do that?
Yeah, I think you are supposed to do an exam, which I can. This is not a problem, but I think the cost will be a problem.
Okay, and how much does it cost right now?
Now, it really depends on the situation, but $100,000 to $300,000.
Okay, wow.
So that's more than the house itself.
I mean, you can almost buy U.S. citizenship for that much. Yeah. For about 500.
Really?
Yeah. That's shockingly high for Cambodia.
Yeah. It went up with the Chinese arrived here, so it used to be like $10,000 or $20,000.
Yeah.
I should have bought it then, back then.
Wow, that's really crazy. That is so much money.
Maybe I'll get married and get it for free.
Yeah, there you go. Can do a lot with that much money.
Yeah. You know, I should consider selling it. Like, someone can get the Czech citizenship by marrying me, so.
Yeah.
But okay. I could do an exchange with someone.
Exchange in more ways than one.
You're right. Equal to have two, right? For them also, because Czech passport, you can travel to many countries without a visa, like Dubai or Japan.
Yes, yes.
Like, for Cambodian passport, it's still complicated to get visa sometimes.
So have you dated many local men or women or whatever you're into?
Yeah, both.
But didn't work out so far?
Not really, yeah. There is one for 15 years, but I still, I don't know, I haven't decided.
I haven't pulled the trigger yet, okay. Getting personal in this vlog, all right. It's very interesting. And Do you find that it's culturally easy or difficult to date local people?
It's difficult. Even though he spent 10 years in Europe, it's still difficult.
Okay. Oh, he spent 10 years
here? Yeah.
Oh, wow. Okay.
And I spent 10 years here, but it's still difficult.
Yeah.
So, I don't know. Just gonna give up.
So, is Cambodia like a lot of Asian countries where they generally want to move to the US or to Europe, or are they aren't interested in that?
They are, and there are lots of people abroad as well, working and studying in Australia, in US, and in Europe as well. There is a community of Cambodian people.
Yeah, I guess you might not notice that unless you spend time here and paid attention to Cambodian.
But it's always a small community because it's a small country after all. So it will never be big like a Chinese community in any country. It's pretty small. But there are like maybe tens of people in Prague.
So yeah, for those of you who don't know, I mean, Cambodia is not even as large as the city of Shanghai, for example. So it's only about, 16 million people?
Yeah, that's right.
So it's a relatively small country by Asian standards, especially. So you hang out with a lot of Chinese folks and some local people?
Yeah, local people as well, but when I think about it, I don't have a real local friend.
Okay, so maybe it's been more difficult to get close to them, or?
Yeah, I think still they are looking at us foreigners like we are not one of them. They are friendly, yes, but they expect us to pay, or I don't know. They just treat us like, we are supposed to have a lot of money and we should pay for everyone local. I mean, I don't mind sometimes, but it's not really nice.
Yeah.
Chinese people are really nice. They really take me as a real friend. Maybe it's the language, because my Khmer is okay, but it's not as good as my Chinese.
Ah,
so
yes.
It could be.
And also, they're also immigrants here.
Yeah,
so
we are all foreigners, so
that's very interesting.
Well.
This is a very interesting to hear you talk about this, because I just moved to Thailand from the United States myself, so I'm curious to hear what my future has in store for me.
Well, Thailand I visited many times, but the people are friendly as well, but in a different way, I guess.
Yes, it definitely seems Thailand, I think, because it's such an international tourist destination, and also because they speak fairly good English by Asian standards, a lot of expats enjoy living there. There are a lot of expats in Thailand, and so it's easier for them to sort of stay with other expats. And
Thailand is cheaper as well.
A lot of things in Cambodia seem cheaper at first, like transportation, alcohol are definitely two things that are much cheaper than Thailand. Some food seems cheaper, other food maybe not. But yeah, I looked at apartments yesterday and was, for high-end apartments, was actually surprised that that they were not better for the price that was being asked.
Yeah, not very good.
For example, for $5,000 in Bangkok, you can have a 2 or 3 bedroom in the Ritz-Carlton.
You mean rent?
Yeah, for rent. And that's one of the newest, nicest, most exclusive buildings in all of Southeast Asia. And here, looking at apartments for $5,000 a month was nothing very impressive. So that's very interesting to hear. What do you think is the most expensive thing here that you would think would be less expensive it's relatively expensive compared to Europe or wherever.
Everything is expensive. Okay. Even vegetables, meat, milk, bread, everything is expensive here. Compared to Czech Republic, we were just saying, like, everything is more expensive.
So you must just really love it here to live here. It's not for the cost. So we are finally here at a Rusi market. Okay, guys, I hope that was informative for those of you who are thinking about moving to Cambodia. Check out these other videos about my short trip there, including food, real estate, and everything else that an expat needs to know. Thanks so much.